Fear's behind it all. That's what I'm getting at. All these problems that we experience in the world, from that little kid bugging that other little kid at the schoolyard, to war, poverty, and environmental catastrophe, all of them originate with fear in someone's heart. It gets in there and says,
ah, you need a new car, you need a new girlfriend, you need new everything, otherwise you're going to be miserable for the rest of your life.
Fear. Now, what's crazy about this is that what starts out as a psychological reality, me being afraid, soon becomes a social reality, me and how I affect other people. And eventually it can affect everyone, because as I said before, fear is contagious. I scare you, you scare him, and so on. We have a common enemy, one that's destroying our whole world, one that should unite us against it, and that's fear. And if you want to know the damage that fear does, you don't have to look too far.
Children standing here, arms outstretched into the sky, tears drying on their face. He has been here. Brothers lie in shallow graves, fathers lost without a trace, a nation blind to their disgrace since he's been here. And I see no bravery, no bravery in your eyes anymore, this sadness. And I see no bravery, no bravery in your eyes anymore, this sadness. Only sadness. Houses burnt beyond repair, smell of death is in the air. A woman weeping in despair says he has been here. Tracer lighting up the sky, it's another family's turn to die. A child afraid to even cry out says he has been here. And I see no bravery, no bravery in your eyes anymore, only sadness. And I see no bravery, no bravery in your eyes anymore, only sadness. There are children standing here, arms outstretched into the sky, but no one asks the question why.
Song by James Blunt, by the way, about fear. Look at what fear has done. to destroy the world. But what this means is that if we want to conquer all of these evil forces in the world, what we have to do is go after the individual human heart and cure it of its fear. Of course, that always starts with this heart right here. Now, because fear starts off as both a psychological and becomes a social problem, it's going to need both a psychological and a social solution. I would call that a spiritual solution. The spirit being about my own soul in communion with everyone else's. And that's where religion comes in. Or at least where it's supposed to come in. Sometimes, and I'm sure you can think of many examples yourself, religion actually gets used to perpetuate fear. But that's never the intent of those religions' founders. Ultimately, it will come down to religion. To cure us of our fear of ourselves, of each other, of the universe as a whole. And ultimately, whatever religion that is, it's going to have to be a religion whose purpose is to convey and to communicate love. And now we're getting good. See you next week.